Hello guys, welcome back to Change Journey. In previous video, we have seen Alvin's opening from wide perspective and also seen some strategies to win the game easily. If you haven't seen that video, click the link in the description or click here to watch that video. In this video, we are going to see how to play as a black and respond correctly for Alvin's opening to gain the advantage. Basically, there are two ways to respond. First is to attack the center as well as try to capture e4 pawn from the center. And the second way is to play solid, that is defend the center square which are covered by white pieces and then attack. So starting with the first strategy, as we know main line is e4, e5, knight to e2, then d5 attacking the unsupported e4 pawn. In this condition white can play other developing moves like knight to c3, but after d4 knight has to go back, or if knight pushed on this square then by pawn push knight is gone. Thus, most of the time, white will capture the d5 pawn, then queen cross d5, knight to c3 attacking the queen, queen to e5 controlling the kingside diagonal. Here, most likely played move for white is d4, which will free up the bishop path, covers the center, and attack on e5 pawn. Even if e cross d4, then knight cross d4 will free up the light square bishop. So, in this condition, mostly d4 is played. Then we have to play knight to c6. Protecting the e5 pawn and invite white to push d4. White will accept the invitation and play d5. Here we have to play knight to b6, counter attacking the d5 pawn. After this, black's queen is still keeping the pin on knight along the diagonal. So to lose that pin, bishop to d2 is better move for white. Then we will play bishop to c5, pressurizing the c2 square. White has no other move except rook to c1. Then bishop cross c2 attacking the queen. In this position, white has to give up his queen in exchange of knight and bishop or will be checkmated. So if rook captures the bishop, then knight to d3 is checkmate. In the beginning, I have said that there are two ways to respond. Here we are done with the first one. Back to the second move. Another way to respond is bishop to c5, controlling the center square. In previous video, we have seen that white's plan is to open up the king's side if e4 pawn is not attacked. So by that continuation, white will play f4, then queen to f6, attacking the white's kingside pawn. Usual reply is pawn to g3. Then to maintain the development from the kingside, knight to h6. Here black pieces are eyeing on white's kingside, so most of the time bishop to g2 is played to free up the rook space. Then we have to play knight to g4, threatening fork on f2, and thus rook to f1. Controlling the f2 square. Then knight cross h2, grabbing the extra pawn and attacking the rook at the same time. In this position, repetitive moves can be played like rook back to the h1, knight to g4. But black is a pawn up and all three pieces are eyeing on f2 square, pressurizing the white's king side. So if most of the pieces are exchanged carefully, then black can win this game easily. But white want to play aggressively and capture the e5 pawn. Here main threat is that if rook is captured, then queen is gone. But after queen cross f1 check, bishop cross f1, knight to f3 is a beautiful checkmate. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you are watching the video so far, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon. Before ending the video, we are going to solve previous puzzle. Here we have to follow 14 sequence. So queen cross c8 check, bishop cross c8, knight to c7 check, king to b8, knight to c6 check, king to b7, knight to b5 check. If king goes to either a6 or a8, then rook to a7 is a checkmate. So bishop to d7, but after rook cross d7 check, king to c8, rook to c7 is a checkmate. Here is the next puzzle for you. It's black to move and mate. Answer this in comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye.